Mais um episódio da nossa série com Stephen Meyer. E a grande pergunta de hoje é: quais são as principais evidências que defendem a ideia de um design inteligente?
Well, some of the main evidences or indicators of actual design, in our opinion, are things such as the miniature machines that have been discovered in even the very simplest living cells, the rotary engines, the sliding clamps, the miniature robotic walking motor proteins, the little turbines. In the cell, in living cells, microbiologists, molecular biologists, biochemists have discovered an exquisite realm of nanotechnology. And these features of life have a property that our colleague Michael Behe has described as irreducible complexity. And these irreducibly complex systems are systems that we think cannot arise through a gradual Darwinian process, but instead bespeak the activity of a designing intelligence. Whenever we see systems that have that property of irreducible complexity, where many parts are working in close coordination in order to give the system as a whole its function, invariably they are the product, systems like that are the product of intelligent design. Another feature of living systems that points to the reality of a designing intelligence is the presence of information in the DNA molecule and other structures within living organisms. In 1953, when Watson and Crick elucidated the structure of DNA with its beautiful double helix structure, they realized that DNA could carry information in the form of a four-character digital code. 5 years later, Francis Crick proposed his famous sequence hypothesis, which suggested that the chemical subunits along the spine of the DNA molecule are functioning like alphabetic characters in a written text, or like the zeros and ones in a section of software, which is to say that the physical properties of those chemical subunits, and they're called bases or nucleotide bases, the physical properties of those chemical subunits are not what give DNA its function, but rather what gives it its function is the specific arrangement of those chemicals functioning as alphabetic characters in a code, in accord with an independent code or symbol convention, which we now call the genetic code. So it turns out that DNA actually stores information in a digital form, much like a computer code. In fact, Bill Gates, the software developer here in our Seattle area, has said that DNA is like a software program, but much more complex than any we've ever created. And we know that software comes from a programmer. And indeed, whenever we find information in a digital or alphabetic form, and we trace it back to its source, whether we're talking about a software program, or a paragraph in a book, or a headline in a newspaper, or a hieroglyphic inscription, or even information that's embedded in a radio signal, when we trace that information back to its source, we always come to a mind, not a material process. So one of the key arguments for intelligent design is that the discovery of that information at the foundation of life and even the simplest living cells provides a powerful indicator of the activity of a designing intelligence in the history of life.
Se você gostou desse vídeo, não se esqueça de deixar o seu like e se inscrever no canal. E até o próximo episódio dessa série incrível com Stephen Meyer.